Lao Tzu said, act without doing, work without effort. Think of the small as large and the few as many. Confront the difficult while it's still easy. Accomplish the great task by a series of small acts. A master never reaches for the great. Thus he achieves greatness. When he runs into a difficulty, he stops and gives himself to it. He doesn't cling to his own comfort. Thus problems are no longer problems for him. Confronting the difficult is easy if you've mastered your emotions. The large appears small when your heart lies in your hands, not bouncing around in your chest or worn on your sleeve. Small acts refer to questioning your inner forces. Your thoughts and feelings are constantly disagreeing with one another. You're a master in training. Therefore, train yourself with small acts. They'll add up to greatness over time. Don't cling to the comfort of money. Money can't buy you out of your fear of death. If you're not afraid of dying, you're sound asleep at the wheel. The loved ones you've lost are gone, but some of the voices inside you yearn to replace those you lost. Speak to those voices. Correct them when they're wrong. Congratulate them when they're right. In this way, you'll honor the dead by coming more alive. The voices of your enemies, those who've deceived, betrayed, and hurt you, are available in your mind to embrace as well. Talk in loud to your enemies. Don't make peace with them. Work on understanding their frailty and weaknesses. Work to understand your magnanimity and grace. When you see yourself as frail and weak, apologize to that voice inside you. Resolve to do better next time. Promise that part of yourself that you'll improve cautiously and slowly. You are now partially woke. You are awakening. Be contemptuous of those who are sleeping through life. Your courage in awakening will reveal your virtuous reasons for being here. Torah expresses the virtues of Moses as well as his anger, vices, and self-ignorance. The same is true about Jesus in the Gospels. The Quran expresses this about Muhammad. For you to discover the complexity of being you in this modern age we live in, you need to apply the wisdom of all three of the Abrahamic tests. That's why God gave them to us. Good thoughts. We'll talk more tomorrow about how the East and West meet through paradox.